Hello everyone, and welcome to this special Swiss celebration video. So if you haven't seen already in the forums and bits and pieces, we currently have a sale on and a new bundle, mainly on tier C, but also is on TSW as well. So it's to celebrate Swiss National Day. So we're going to run a couple of routes. So we're going to run the Bernina Pass with the ABE 44-3s, and then we're going to run the Gotthard Bahn as well. So yes, so we'll start off with this, and let's get into it. So as you can see, there's all the routes on sale. So you've got Bernina Line, Gotthard Bahn, Albula, Lake Constance, all the RHB packs as well, all on enhancement packs, all on sale as well. So all of them can have up to, some of them have got up to 70% off. So if you love your Swiss and you haven't quite got into it yet, great time to go and pick them up. So here we are with the ABE dash threes. So one is in the UNESCO World Heritage livery, and the other is in the Bernina Line anniversary, which was 100 years in 2010. So it's now 120. No, 100. And, what did I say? 123. 113 years old. Now the ABEs are great units. They're mainly, I would sort of call them more than locos really. They were built as sort of passenger units, but they can be separated into ones. But most of the time you'll see them double head as a main source. But a lot of the time now you'll see them mainly on the Bernina Express actually. As well as these, the Allegras. See. Lots of the units in Switzerland all their own trains. Pantographs up. I'll give you some history for the AB. Right, passengers now aboard of the train, please proceed at 11:12 to your turn. The side door stop is Pontresina. The signal is clear for departure. Yep, we're clear. Speed set. Off we go with the Bernina Express. Across the road, leaving from St. Moritz. Steep gradient we're on, just keep the brakes on. Start changing our bike bit. Keep the speed nice and steady. There we go. So a little bit of history about the ABE 443. There was only actually ever six built. And there's six of them are still all in service, which is quite incredible. quite a small service unit. I have a maximum speed of 40 miles an hour, so they're quite slow machines. I have a weight of 47 tonnes, they were built between 1988 and 1990. So yeah, they're quite, not very many machines of them. And that's actually something I thought there was more of them, so. Our brakes lower down so we can reach 40 mile an hour. There we go, bring our brakes down. You can see we're going quite down the gradient. Lovely little station here. I love all these wooden buildings. As I've said numerous times, and you'll probably know me well if you watch my streams, I've been to Switzerland quite a few times. It's a beautiful country. Now put the power down as we're now going to go up a gradient. Reflection there. Sorry, my mouse stopped working for me. Before you ask, this is a pre-recorded video as well, so if you've got any questions, please feel free to put them in the forums. So a little bit of history about the Bernina Express. It's quite a unique journey. It depends on which way you go from, as there's two different locations you can start your Bernina Express journey from. So you can start from Chur, and goes right through to Tirano in Italy, or you can go from St Moritz. But there's around 55 tunnels and 196 bridges. So yes, it's quite incredible. One of the most highest mainline stations as well. And also interestingly, this year the Bernina Express celebrates 50 years, so it's like a dual celebration as well. It started running on the 3rd of June 1973, and since then it's had roughly, this is quite incredible, roughly 10 million guests on a panoramic coaches. 10 million, which is quite incredible. Far away from Pontresina. Come on, mates. the cab. You can have a 30 mile an hour limit coming up. I'll just reduce my speed, we'll let it roll. See our signals now coming up to warn us. This is the line coming from St Mabel. So a lot of the trains actually, there's a connecting train. So the Bonina Express, if you were coming from Kerr, I think would actually avoid St Moritz and go through this section from St Mabel straight up to Tirano. Our signals now warning us our entrance. As you can see, we're already under the 30 mile an hour limit. Steady stop in Montesina. Go across the to the end of the platforms, we'll get all the coaches in. There we go. So yes, the other interesting thing is with the Bonina Express, so I think in the first two coaches for the power units, it's sort of considered as actually not part of the Bonina Express, so you could just I think you can just use a normal ticket in this section. Probably someone from the LHB will probably tell me wrong, but I have a funny feeling that you can. Yeah, normally you'd be timetabled, so a train coming down from Tirano, or coming from Tirano, there would normally be, as soon as you come in, a connecting train, and you go under the subway. I've done it a couple of times, so you can link with a train coming out of St Moritz at St Maiden, and just hop over. It's quite good. Successful stop. Please proceed 11:23 to your next time to Osprey Bonina. When the signal is clear for departure. I think we've got a clear signal, and it started to rain. It's a shame. A bit like the weather at the moment. I think I've put Osprey Bonina. Probably pronounced that wrong. Over the crossing. The steep gradient we go. We'll be able to increase to 35 miles an hour. As you can see, how steep the railway is. So if we go and somewhere up there, look at this, look at the shape of that. Yeah. And the ABE threes normally always double head. You don't normally see them as single units. They're always together, just to give more power. I don't think we've got a request stop this time. I had a practice go earlier and we had a request stop. All good. So be able to increase to 65. There we go, that's our 65, so we'll bring the power up now. Marking for the pantographs. Follow the white and blue brackets as well. River. The water's always clear in Switzerland. Valley widens out of here. We are in the panoramic coaches. See, they are lovely. That gives you the full map of the RHB there. It's a massive network, all on meter gauge. As you can see, this is the part of the network we are in. So yeah, we're currently up here. And this is what I mean by the section here. So here's the Maiden up here. This is Samaritz up here, and this is the switchback that you can connect with. So the Bernina line has actually always been electrified. And reaching of height of the biggest height is 2,253 metres, or 7,300 times 2 feet above sea level. it's the highest railway crossing in Europe, the third highest railway in Switzerland. So it's very, very high. It also ranks as the highest adhesion railway of Europe, with an incline of 7%. It's one of the steepest adhesion railways in the world. So yes, it's quite an amazing feat. So let's drop down, back down to 35. Put some brakes on. The whole line itself opened on the 5th of July 1910. And started with electrification from the offset. There's 22 stations, and it's 37, just under 38 miles long. So it's a very small. Hello, we've got a request stop. Let's do a stop here. As you can see, we're currently on the flat there, and we have to go up to that height. Make doors are shut before I... Here we go, we are now starting to climb. Nice waterfall there. Then as we come further up here, it's one of the most interesting sections, or one of the most. You've got a road crossing right on a curve, and over there is a glacier on that side. The famous sound of Swiss level crossings. You need to drop down to 30 miles an hour because it's quite a steep curve. Sharp curve, sorry, not steep. Well, it is steep and it's sharp. Steepness, is that thing? Look at that. As you can see, we've now completely changed sides. We're now going the same direction as what we were before, so we actually came back on ourselves. We're now going on slightly the faster section now. Increase our speed slightly. Maybe it sort of starts to level out. Increase the speed there. There's also some GEM 44s that were built for the locomotives that were built for the line, and they are diesel electro locos. They don't have passenger carrying capabilities themselves, but they can, if there's any issues with the overhead power lines, then they can be used to haul the trains if need be. Our speed. Turn off the wipers now, I think it's stopped raining, isn't it? Now follow the road. Also note, interestingly, and this is true, the road and the railway doesn't have much of a wall or fence next to each other. Something I notice. Something you don't often see. Down to 30 just in case. Request stops are all good. Passing a Allegra on the way down. Way to Samaritz. Calling a supermarket container. We need to drop down to 40. We're now coming to quite an interesting location. It's got a massive cable car that runs up. Now passing the Swiss carriage as well. Quick question, have we got a request stop? Let's see where the request stop sign was. Oh. I think we're okay. anyway. There in the end. Rain starts again. That was a good call. And we haven't got a request stop, so that's good. Up to 45. You can see how steep the line is. Getting up to quite an interesting section. It's quite steep up there and into a rock slide and snow cover. There we go. Drop down to 40. There we go. to go back up to 45, and we've got to drop 10 again. Lovely lakes along this part of the line. That puts some gates down. Train roll, so we can go back down to 35. Lovely reflections in the water there. Quite a steep curve, harsh curve, you can see it. Here we come to the top of the line, and as you can see, altitude 7,403 feet. We got off at this station and had a walk down here. Beautiful location. You can even hear the cows on the mountains opposite, all their bells ringing. Let the gradient do the work for us. That 3 minutes early as well. So in this little building here, this is where the snow plows are kept, including the steam rotary snow plow, which is still in use. They use it for special events. It's another being an express waiting. slightly too early. There's a nice little cafe in here as well, in the buffet there. So what we'll do now is we'll now move over to, from the RHB, oh yeah, I'm wearing a Swiss Railway top as well. So I've got these, this is a G45 RHB steam locomotive. So we're now going to move over to the Gotthard line, and I'll be back in just a couple of minutes. And I'm back, everyone, and we're on the Gotthard Bahn with a class 523, I think it is. I'll double check in a second. on this destination, set up a screen to code 204, then press the enter key to set the destination displays. Right, so it's put to 4 on there. Press the enter key. Now you're going to Ersfeld. Open the doors, get the headlights on. Yes, I was right, it is a 523. So these are the SBB Flirts, Stadler Flirts. They're all very different versions of them. We've got them here in locally to me as well in East Anglia, running from Greater Anglia. These ones are just the pure electrics. They have a top speed of 125 miles an hour. So quite speedy machines. Passengers have now boarded the train. Proceed at 1401. Next stumble stop is BSA when the signal is clear for departure. Right, I think we're clear. Get our windows open so we can hear some loco sounds. Make sure we get the speed limits on as well. And I had to run the Gotthard Bahn in the snow, because why not? What's the point, where we go? Great thing is this loco's got cruise unit. Calling it a loco unit, has cruise control, so push it up. It's not a clear signal. Now push up to 100 kilometers an hour. Quite fast acceleration. Down to 90, so we'll bring the cruise control down. That will automatically brake for us. We're not far from the Italian border, this side of the Gotthard Bahn. So yes. RE460 waiting for us. I think it's a 460. Me trying to do a nice shot. Yeah, it's an RE460. Straight through here. That's better. service as well. These are quite nice units, quite comfortable. Oh, we can go up to 120 now. We'll put the speed limiter up and we'll soon increase. So a little bit of history about the Gotthard Bahn. It was fully opened on the 1st of June 1882. It was mainly a single track section when it first opened, and had to have extensions. I think one of the last parts of the Gotthard Bahn to have to go double track was actually in 1965. So it took them a good few years to double track some of the sections of the Gotthard Bahn. The line length is 216 kilometres or 134 miles. It opened with steam originally, and it had quite a few interesting locomotives that were designed for it. I think it was electrified in the early part of the sort of 1920s, 1930s. So yes, it was quite an early electrification. The Crocodiles was one of the first electric locomotives that was designed, but they did use steam right up till the late days. I think about the 1960s, I think they were still using steam. The steam was still used as sort of banking and snow ploughing locomotives, and they still had steam snow rotary snow ploughs as well. One of the most famous locomotives that the SBB had, which was for steam, was called, nicknamed the Elephant, which was the C56 class. And don't forget, we've got the bundle that's out at the moment. There's a new bundle that we've done for the celebration. So you get the Gotthard Bahn. You get the Rosa line, as well as I think it's pack number 5, RHB pack number 5, enhancement pack, and core gang as well for transport classic. So if you want to get into your Swiss, that's a good way to start off. Because we've got a 120 limit, I was going to increase the speed, but I didn't need to really, because we've got a stop coming on anyway, or slower speed anyway. Got 2523 units. Also, the thing with the Stadler Flirts is they've been used in many, many different countries, and to all different types of design. There's not one flirt that fits sort of the area it goes to. So a lot of them have been redesigned for the area that they run in. These 523s are mainly the Swiss only versions, but the SBB have got other Stadler Flirts that can run into Germany and into France, and I think probably into Italy as well. clear signal, so we're doing okay. We're doing all right for time. Our ETA is actually quite early, so certainly I'm not complaining. Most trains in Switzerland do always run on time. Here we go, he's in a yellow. We'll have to keep an eye on our next signal. Beautiful scenery, this route. Gotthardbahn is one of the most scenic routes in Switzerland, although there's quite a few. Okay, we're okay, we got a green. Bring our speed down to 80 in a bit. The other thing about the Gotthard line is it's one of the main route arteries between northern and southern Europe, so it sort of links Germany to Italy, so it's quite a famous route. Some of the route, a lot of the route has changed over recent years. Let's keep an eye on the speed. Look at that, time to perfection. So yes. It was actually, as I was saying about electrification, it was 1922 it was electrified. As I say, the route has changed quite a bit with the Gotthard Base Tunnel opening in 2016, so a lot of this area has changed, and a lot of the high-speed trains and freight runs through the Base Tunnel rather than along the Gotthard line itself, or one of the sort of more scenic bits of the Gotthard line. The line itself has 36 tunnels, which is quite incredible. Really need to stop before this signal. Or a unit. Here we go. Love all the snow effects as well on the 523, all the snow weathering all underneath the body. For our permission to go, although as I said, we're quite early. One of the tunnels is actually one of the highest standard gauge railways, or highest tunnel in. It's one of the highest railways. Standard gauge railways, I think, at 3,776 feet, which is quite incredible. And it's also got seven spirals along the line, one of which we'll be going on in just a bit. Wait for our permission. Just holding on the loco brakes. Here comes the snow. It's starting to snow. It looks like rain, but it will turn into snow. Wiper on, I suppose. Slowly releasing the brake and getting permission to part in a second. Passengers now boarded the train. Please proceed at 1416. Next time we'll stop is Fadio, where the signal's clear for next departure. Now we're all clear. Don't know if we'll go all the way to Fadio, but we'll carry on from here. Do you see the fast acceleration of them? You can certainly keep your timetable up with one of these. Get our 95 section so we can increase the speed. There comes the board. There's our 95, so we'll push it. There we go, 5. And then we'll still get permission for 125 then. Gotthard Bahn is one of the locations I haven't been to. It's one of the things I would like to do next time I go over. We're now starting to climb into the mountains now. You can see the valley is getting thinner and thinner. Five just come up to the back end of the train, which is there. And there's the construction of the Gotthard Base Tunnel, just there. As you can see, we then go off to the left and start increasing in height. So we've now got to reduce our speed, so we go down to 105. Most of the high-speed services would go down the Gotthard Base Tunnel now. And as we're more of a local train, we'll then head up on the original Gotthard Pass. We dip over the top. We've got to drop down to 95. we've soon got to drop down to 80. Starts to get twisty and turny. We'll probably start reducing now. The electronic brakes do the work. See, here's the full Gotthard arm. We are currently up here, starting to get to a very interesting section of the line. You see beautiful blue waters as well. Currently we're now getting very near our first spiral section, as you can see there. Pass through one of the nice stations. I think it's a closed one now. We'll then move along to our first section. So this is one of the quite famous sections as we go into the bottom end. We'll then come out on the top on there, on this section, where has it gone? There, the top, and then you'll come over up the top up there. As you can see, the gradient is increasing as well, just before we go into the tunnel. Also, that's where the new motorway at the top there, or, well, it's not that new, but one of the newer motorways that's been put in. Here it comes. Into the tunnel we go. We're currently in here. coming out of the first tunnel now. Go out of the first tunnel. We're now in this section here. We're now entering the next tunnel. Do this spiral here. That's the section we've just been on. That's the spiral section we've just gone through. So you can see, came through that one. That's the spiral out to that one. And now we're coming out on this spiral section now. Here we come. As you can see how much height we have gained. Just quite a lot. Limits back down to 60. We know where the next signal is, so we can probably time it. Wasn't as well timed that time. We'll run to the next station and then we'll finish there. Is our 80. So you can see we've just crossed over sections. One interesting thing with the Gotthard line, it's bi-directional. I think pretty much the whole section of the Gotthard line is all bi-directional. but as a rule of thumb, trains towards Switzerland run on the right, and trains towards Italy run on the left, which way we're facing, obviously. So you can see we've just come over to the left because we're running bi-directional. The reason why we've probably come over to the left is the platform is probably only on the left-hand side. So that's why with lesser traffic. Yeah, as you can see, there's a train sitting in platform two, hence why we're crossed over. We've got green signals, so we're all okay. We're nearly there now. I think the platform is around there somewhere, I think. Nearly round the corner. As you can see why the Gotthard base tunnel was built. As you can see, the Gotthard line is quite a slow line, you know, compared to the Gotthard, you know, the Gotthard base tunnel. I think can do high speed. I can't remember the exact speed limit the Gotthard based on. It would certainly be faster than running on the Gotthard line. See all the cows there? But it's good that the original Gotthard line is still kept open for beautiful sightseeing. And there's our station we're looking for. Still climbing well. We're now coming into our platform. Starting to increase the speed now. I think. Let's open the doors So there we go. That is our Swiss celebration videos for today. Don't forget, it was all pre-recorded. Sale is still on. Go and pick up some Swiss content if you love your Swiss railways and locomotives and units. So yes, we'll be back very soon, and hope you enjoy all the Swiss celebrations. Take care, everyone. See you later.